Hey, it's Truckin' Tank Yanker. If you got arthritis, stay tuned.
Bragger, bragger, this is the Truckin' Tanker Yanker. I'm 10-8 with my 10 in the wind. My ears are glowing, my manners are showing. Wind her up, let her go, come on. I'm your travel agent with a story to tell. Let's go for a ride.
All right, Truckin' Tank Yanker, I'm back. Now, I just got a pro tip for all of you with arthritis. All right, I got arthritis, and I got rheumatoid arthritis, and I got another kind called ankylosing spondylitis. You can look that one up in a dictionary or something. And lately here, it's been really getting to me. And it's because I've been off my diet, and so I decided I better get back on my diet. That means I gotta throw things like this away. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, there we go. There you go. I was saving that for an emergency. It's Smucker's breakfast syrup. I got it sometime in the past to dip my little French toast sticks you get in a truck stop. You dunk them in there like this and eat your French toast stick. And I'm realizing I've been off of sugar for a week. Already the arthritis is starting to help. Some of the swelling is going down, and it is painful still, but it's going down. But I better throw this away. I'm gonna throw it in the garbage, and I'm cleaning my truck out today, so when I put it in the garbage here, and it's in the garbage now, I'm not gonna take it out, but it's in the garbage and it's going. Otherwise, middle of next week, I'll probably end up drinking that little thing.
Pass the maple syrup, please.
But I'm just saying, if you want to help your arthritis, your sore back, your all the maladies you got to quit eating garbage. That means you can't eat at a truck stop. You ever walk into... I just call my daughter, all right? She don't like talking to people on the phone, but we call her the food Nazi at my house. And she will clue you into everything that will hurt you, which is nearly everything, all right? You have to eat stuff that's either would run around wild, or growing wild, or grew it in a garden, or grew it by hippies, or something like that. If you eat stuff like that, then you're going to be in better shape. And I had lost a whole lot of weight eating that stuff, because you kind of lose your zest for living, I guess, from eating that. But I lost a lot of weight, and my arthritis got better. I got off of, believe it or not, I was on $200,000 a year worth of drugs. And I was not getting any better. And the last thing that the doctor told me was, that's it. That's all we can do for you. Now it's called pain management. And I said, that's just not a good option. I'm much too young to quit working now and be an invalid. So I went on this lousy diet. And I tell you what, I got better. But I've talked to people whose fingers are pointing south in a lot of pain. And I told them about this diet. And they just prefer to have fingers pointing south and in a lot of pain than go on the diet. Yeah, to each his own. All right? So, it's called the GAPS diet. You can buy the book as, I don't remember what it's called, GAPS, I guess. Somebody, Nev Campbell, wrote the book, a lady doctor in the UK, and we followed it, and I'll tell you what, it's really helped. This diet has really helped us. So, if you want to call this a PSA or a sponsorship or something like that along those lines, yeah, I just tell you about what I believe in. And I think this here works. So I'm going off of sugar. Now, drivers, what I got to suggest for you is if you're going to go on to get off of sugar and don't eat bread and potatoes and things like that, if you're going to go off on this diet like that, make sure that it's right when you go on the road for 6 weeks or so, all right? Pack a lot of food with you, because you ain't going to find nothing decent to eat it where you go if you follow that book. You can get it on Amazon, by the way. And it really works. It solves a whole bunch of problems. Even schizophrenia, bipolar, depression. A lot of those things are biochemical. They're not just mood. Some of it has to do with you act yourself into a better way of feeling or a worse way of feeling. I'm just saying. But biochemical. And so when you change what's going on, the chemistry in your body, you're going to change what your body's doing to try to kill itself, which is basically what autoimmune diseases are. Your body trying to kill itself. And my body's been trying to kill me for a long time. I'm just saying. But I got kids that it's helped an awful lot. My wife, it's helped an awful lot. So you could say I'm a believer. maybe not real knowledgeable. I just do what I'm told, whatever the food Nazi says in my house. But generally speaking, and she doesn't think I'm doing what she told me here lately in the last year or so. But yeah, and I'm getting back to it. I'm going to do a restart and because I'm in pain. And the main thing is, it's like, okay, I can deal with pain, but if I can't play my guitar, I can't deal with that. I got to be able to play with my guitar. So that's where I'm going to go back on the diet to a better extent than what I have been, and getting off all this other stuff. So, but if you're going to get off of sugar and wheat and all that kind of stuff for, you know, to get started on this diet, make sure you hit the road for about 6 weeks, because you're going to be a bear to live with. I'm just saying. Probably ought not to do this in a high stress, high traffic area like New York, Washington, D.C., Northeast, anywhere, Denver, L.A., Seattle. Don't do it around there, because you're just going to run people into the borrow pit or the median. You're going to be terrible on the road. You're going to be just a bear to deal with. And so I do this when I went without sugar all this last week. I haven't talked to anybody from at home because I want you nobody's head off. Next week, I'll just be drinking broth. I'm going to be bearish then, because I'm going to be hungry all week, probably. There you go. But, hey, already it's starting to help. I don't know, they look like meatballs anyway, but there you go. So, that's just a PSA. If you want it from a driver who used to spend $200,000 a year, it wasn't my money, it was somebody else's, $200,000 a year worth of medications from Blue Cross Blue Shield. Well, it cost me $9,000 with my total out-of-pocket. That cost me every year. I paid it in January and February. Every year, I had to pay my $9,000, which was my total out-of-the-pocket, because I knew it was going to cost me all of that with just in a month. But anyway, you want to get away from that kind of stuff. Hey, some of you are in the know. Remicade, that was what I was on. I was on the max dose, 1,200 milligrams for my body weight. I was on the max dose. Max dose of NSAIDs. I changed my NSAIDs like 4 different times because of my liver enzymes going up. I was on the max dose of methotrexate. Some of you know what that is, especially those of you who have gone through cancer treatment and stuff like that. It's a chemotherapy drug to suppress your immune system. I was on a max dose of that. I gave myself a shot every week, and that sure made me ill. I was on drugs for my drugs. I took, what was that little pill that I took, because the other ones killed my stomach. So I took a pill for that, and because they all wore me out. I mean, it's like the day I got my 4 hours to get Remicade. Some of you know what I'm talking about. 4-hour infusion to get my Remicade at a doctor's office, and then I come out of there feeling like I just run a marathon, which I don't run anything. I run a truck, all right. And I felt like I'd run a marathon. I'd had to drink a monster just when I left the infusion because I was so wore out. Well, I took pills because I fall asleep at 3:00 in the afternoon because of all the other pills I took. I took a pill to keep me awake, and it was just, that pill was $30 a pill. I couldn't believe that. You know, the other stuff was more expensive, but that was a ridiculous amount of money to stay awake. And but if you just want to get to feeling better, check out that GAPS diet book. You know, I'm not getting paid by anybody to tell you about this. And as many people have I told about it, nobody really even cares. They just soon go get medicated. And by the way, there's a great song called Medicate. I don't remember who sings it. Some hard rock group. And how about We Are All on Drugs by Weezer? Look that one up. That's a good one. I like that. Watch the video. All right, I'm not that anymore, all right? I'm the Truck and Tank Anchor, that's who I am. I'm not on drugs, even if they were prescribed. So, I'm just on diet. I'm on fruits and nuts. That's what I'm on, fruits and nuts. Well, I actually can't eat no fruit. Real little on the nuts. You can eat a lot of meat, a lot of fat, a lot of meat. You can do eggs when you get used to them, some cheese. Anyway, it's all up to you, you know, hey. To each his own. I'm a libertarian. I'm just saying. You want to feel painful? Yeah, go ahead. Feel painful. You know, but I'm a Truck and Tank Anchor, and I got things I got to do, places to go, people to see, things to do. I can't just say, I can't do that. I'm just not that kind of guy. I can't do that because I'm an old decrepit man when I don't even look that old and decrepit. All right. There you go. That is my long PSA. What has it got here? Printing your 10 minutes. That's a PSA on feeling better. The GAPS diet. Can't remember what that book's called. It's yellow. It's on Amazon. Campbell Nev. Dr. Campbell Nev. Pretty sure that's her name. Or Nev Campbell. Something like that. Wrote the book. You can get it on Amazon. If you want to deal with whatever your autoimmune problem, that will most likely take care of it. It's nearly like snake oil. Just saying. Without the laudanum. I'm just saying. Or opium. But it will help. I know it. Because it has. It's helped thyroid. It's helped mental illnesses. It's helped. And it discussed in the book, you'd be like, how can a diet fix all that? Well, it's all about your intestinal guts and everything and how they operate. So, a lot of people with IBS, and I heard some other new IBS that's the opposite of IBS, constipation BS or something like that. Anyway, I'm just saying. Just check it out. Feel better. Be better. Because I care about you. I'm the Truck and Tanker Yanker. I don't want to lose any audience. I'm just saying. All right? We're going to be building audience here pretty fast. We're going to be building and aiming for the future. Here we go. My retirement. That's what we're aiming for. All right. Truck and Tanker Yanker. Pardon. Take it easy. Keep the shiny side up, the dirty side down. Look beyond your hood ornament and don't be a bumper sticker. All right. Ring the bell. Give me a thumbs up if you like it, this content. If you like family-friendly content, this is as rough as it gets is what I was just here. Give me a thumbs up. All right. Hey, Truck and Tanker Yanker, we gone.